Yeah, so once again, welcome back to VTU eShikshana program. So this is the lecture 7 of the module 3, okay? And before we go to the module 4, wherein we discuss about synchronous counters and then about the different sequential networks, okay? So we'll try to wrap up the module 3, okay, in this particular session, okay? So before we can start with the module 4, okay, with the synchronous counter, we'll try to wrap up. And before we wrap up, we know that a register that goes through a prescribed sequence of distinct states upon the application of a sequence of input pulses is called a counter. Okay. So now what we'll try to do in this particular session is, we'll try to see what all we had studied in this particular. Okay, so this is just a summing up or summary of the module 3. Okay, so we saw what is called as flip-flops. Okay, so we call what is called flip-flops first. Okay, so we had flip-flop, and we had seen there are three classes of flip-flops, right? So one we called as latch, which is a level sensitive. Okay, then we saw the pulse triggered. Okay, the master slave are pulse triggered. Okay, so we could overcome the level sensitive, and we could get what is called as a pulse trigger, wherein the changes in the output with change in the continuous change in the input is overcome. Okay, and we could see the ones and zeros catching in pulse trigger, whereas in latch, which is a level sensitive, we can see the race around condition in JK flip-flop. Okay, and then we saw the last one, which is the edge triggered. Okay, so this is what we had seen. This is the edge triggered, and edge triggered means exactly either at the positive edge, that is rising edge, or at the falling edge, that is the negative edge, we can see the flip-flop is enabled. In rest all condition, my flip-flop is disabled and it will have the previous. In the pulse triggered, okay, if I have this as one cycle, if I have this as one cycle, okay, with 1 and 0, okay, both, it's a 50% duty cycle, on, off, okay. So, my flip-flop output, okay, for whenever the flip-flop is enabled, okay, and when my clock, this is what I mean by the clock, okay, so all these are with respect to my clock, okay. Okay, so when I give a one cycle, okay, this is one cycle, one clock cycle we call, okay, so my flip-flop output, okay, was enabled based on a pulse. Okay, I should get my output when C was going with 0. When it was 1, the flip-flop is enabled, but output was getting, or there was change in the output only when C was going 0. That means when slave was enabled, then only. So this is what we mean by pulse triggered. Whereas in latch, my output will be enabled for complete half cycle, that is when C is completely 1. Okay, for entire hour of duration, my output was changing with respect to input. Here, even though input is changing, my output doesn't change because slave output is what I am interested and all. Okay, so the race around here, there will be a problem with the race around condition with respect to JK flip-flop that I can overcome here, and this overcomes everything now. Okay, all those things. This is what we had studied. And then the application of the flip-flop we had seen in terms of registers and counters. Okay, so we use this flip-flop in register and counters. This is what we have. This is a group of flip-flop, this is a group of flip-flop. Predominantly registers are used to store the information, and also sometimes we will manipulate the information is used. And counters is predominantly used to have a specific prescribed sequence of numbers. Okay, so that is what it does now. Okay, we have already seen what exactly the definition of a register and a counters are. In register, okay, we studied what is called as a shift register. Okay. This is another shift register. Registers. In shift register, we can have one direction, bidirectional, okay, or in general, we can have a universal shift register wherein we can do the shift left, shift right, parallel load, okay, parallel out, all those things. And in counters, we have two types, I said, okay. And one is the ripple binary counter, which I call it as, or it is a asynchronous counter, okay, which we call it as asynchronous counter, or another category of counter is a synchronous counter. Okay, the difference between a ripple or asynchronous with the synchronous is, in synchronous counter all the flip-flops gets a common clock, whereas in ripple or asynchronous counter only one flip-flop will get the main clock and the next subsequent flip-flops will get the output of the previous. Okay, we have something called the cascading kind of thing over here. That is what the two different we had. Okay, this is the flip-flop, which is basically a storage element. If I take, it stores one bit of information. It may be any flip-flop. The okay, different types of flip-flop, we saw SR, okay, we saw JK, we saw T flip-flop, and then D, okay. And finally, we saw the characteristic equation of this. This is S, okay. So, S plus R bar Q is the characteristic equation of this. For JK, it is JQ bar plus K bar Q. For T, it is XOR between T and Q. And for D, it is characteristic equation is Q, the next state equation is equal to D itself. Okay, that's what we saw. Okay. Next, we started with the ripple binary counter. And that too, we started with 4-bit ripple counter, right? 4-bit ripple counter we started with. 4-bit ripple counter. Okay. Predominantly for a ripple counter, we may use T flip-flop or JK shorted, or I can use D flip-flop, wherein each D input will get the complement outputs of its. That's what we have seen even in the previous session, how exactly they are connected. Okay. So in a 4-bit ripple counter, the moment how many flip-flop I use depends upon how many bit the ripple counter is. If I say 4-bit ripple counter, I make use of 4 flip-flop. This is what we had seen. If it is an n-bit ripple counter, I make use of n flip-flop, wherein it can have n bit of information stored and can do that. Okay, that's one. Okay, so this is what. And 4-bit ripple counter is also called as divide by 2 power of 4 counter also. We had seen how exactly I call that as, or okay, or divide by 2 power of 4 or divide by 16 counter. That means it has a sequence from 0 to 15, or I can also call it as mod 2 power of 4 counter, or it is mod 16. When I say mod 16 means I will have the count from 0 to 15. This is what I add. Okay. This is what really happens now. Okay. This is simple. Now, not only this, again, I can do an upcounting by giving the, upcounting can be done by giving the negative edge to the clock. I can do the downcounting by giving the positive edge to the count. That's it. That is the only difference. Okay. Now, can we design something called mod 6 asynchronous, okay, asynchronous, or which we call it as a ripple counter? Can we design this? Yes, this is what we have. Can we design this? Mod 6 means I can have a count from 0 to 5. Here he has not given how many bit this ripple counter is, but he has just asked us mod 6 asynchronous or ripple counter. Yes, the moment I say mod 6, it will count from 0 to 5. The total count is 6 now, right? Now, how many flip-flops we have to use, that depends upon the largest number. Which is the largest number in this? It is 5. So in order to represent 5 in binary, I require 3 bits. Okay? So 3 bits is necessary to represent 5, which is decimal, in binary. Okay? That is 101 in binary is equivalent to 5 in decimal. So how many bits minimum is required? 3 bits. Minimum is important. So I require 3 bits. Okay? So 3 bits means 3 flip-flop. Okay? The moment if they have not given how many bit ripple counter is, first you have to ensure how many bit ripple counter is. How you do? Mod 6 or mod 2 power of, okay, this can't be 2 power of 3, mod 6, 0 to 5. Largest number is 5. In order to represent 5 in binary, I require minimum of 3 bits. So I require 3 flip-flops, okay, to design a mod 6 asynchronous ripple counter. Okay, 3 flip-flop. I'll go with T. This is first flip-flop. This is clock. This is Q. And this is my Q bar. This is first. Is this clear now? This is my clock. Since I told that I make use of 3, this is what? T, C, this is my Q, this is my Q bar, this is flip-flop 2, yes. In the previous example, when I showed the counters, I connected this in terms of vertical, but now I am connecting in terms of horizontal. Both are one and the same. Only thing is how you cascade and all, that is important. Okay, so this is the third thing. Okay, this is T, this is clock. And we know that in asynchronous counter, only one flip-flop will get. So this gets my main clock. This gets my main clock. And in order to perform mod 6, 0 to 5, if it is an up counter, okay, if it is an up counting, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, make sure that we make use of the active low signals over here. Is it clear now? We'll make use of active low. In order to do a down counting, that is from 5, 4, 3, 2, 0, 1, we have to do a thing. Okay, that's what. Clock. And output of the first acting as a clock input for second, we know that. Output of the second is acting as a clock input for third. Yes. This is Q1. This is Q2. This is Q3, right? Yes. And all these T inputs are shorted and they are connected to logic 1 or plus VCC, because I want a toggle condition here. Yes. So to which particular flip-flop I have given the clock, that becomes my least significant. Yes. So now if I want to have this, so I will have something like this. Okay. Q1 will be my least significant. I'll write here. Q3 will be my most significant. Q1, Q2, sorry, Q, yeah, and Q1. So this is my MSP and this is my least significant. Yes. Now, okay, initially by making use of this preset, right? You know that reset. Okay, these are all the clear. All clear are common now. Okay, this is my clear input. How I enable? By providing 0, all the outputs are cleared or reset. Yes. Then I disable this particular input by providing 1. I least worry what is my clock and T when I am enabling this clear, because clear I know it is an asynchronous input. Yes. So initially, all the flip-flop outputs are 0, 0, 0, right? Yes. So, I will provide now the clock input now. This is the falling edge. Based on this clock, I get Q1. Now, Q1 is acting as a clock input of this. Based on Q1, I'll get the output Q2. And based on Q2, because Q2 is acting as a clock, I'll get Q3. Okay? So, this will go from something like this. We'll see. It should have count from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after I should not get 6, but using 3-bit, I get till 8, right? Yes, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 7. So 0 to 7 I get. With 3-bit, maximum number I can represent is 7. So you should be very careful here. Yes. So the moment I should not get 6 here, right? So the moment 6 comes, my flip-flop should all become what? Reset. So when that 6 will happen? 6 will happen when Q3 and Q2 become 1, 1, right? So what I'll do means, the moment Q2 and Q3 both become 1, when both are 1, then only output is 1 means I make use of AND gate. And this AND gate output I will give as the clear input. Okay. Initially I clear all the outputs, that is 0, 0, 0. This is initially I clear. Then I disable my clear. Then I know that the moment I get 1, 1, 0, that is 6 count, it should not display. It should reset to 0. So I know that Q3, Q1, Q3, Q2 and Q1, when it is 1, 1, 0, that is the 6, I ensure that whenever Q2 and Q3 are both 1 simultaneously, I will reset my outputs. So after 5, again I will be getting what? 0, 0, 0. This is what. And this is the basic design of a mod 6 asynchronous ripple counter, which counts only from 0 to 5. And after 5, again I will be having 0 to 5. If I don't connect this AND gate, okay, then this will perform as what? Mod 8, that is 0 to 7. Okay, we'll try to analyze this using the waveform now. Okay. Okay. So now we will have first clock input. Okay. So this is how exactly my clock input is all about. Yes. And I am interested in which particular clock input? The negative edge. Okay. Because I have seen at the clock I have a bubble. So only at the negative edge of the clock, my first flip-flop. First flip-flop output is what? Q1. I am interested in Q1 based on my C. Okay. And initially what? I have reset. So the when the first negative edge comes, since T is, clock is enabled, T is connected to 1, my next output will be complement of previous. Previous is 0, next it will be 1, and it will remain 1 for the till the next. And after that what? Since T is continuously 1, for the next clocks it becomes 0. And next it becomes 1, next it becomes 0, next it becomes 1, something like this, right? 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Then this Q1 is acting as a clock input for second flip-flop, for which I get the T. So since Q1 is acting as a clock input, I am interested in the negative edge of this now. Yes. So initially it is 0 and it will be 0 until the first clock input comes, that is Q1 is becoming negative. Then it becomes the alternate toggle, 0 to 1 toggle, 1 to 0 toggle. Okay. This is 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay. Next, in order to get the output of third flip-flop, Q2 I'm interested in, which is acting as a clock input for this, right? So Q3 will be enabled only after Q2. So that's why, and initially this is Q, and again I'm interested in the negative edge. Okay. Till, and then it becomes 1. So if I take this as something like a 1, this is first clock pulse, this is second clock cycle, this is my third clock cycle, This is my fourth clock cycle. This is my fifth clock cycle. This is my sixth clock cycle. And again it continues. Okay, we'll see. Now, in the first clock cycle, all are 0, 0. In the second clock cycle, it is 1, 0, 0. In the third clock cycle, it is 0, 1, 0. In the fourth clock cycle, it is 1, 0, 0. Sorry, it is 1, 1, 0. Sorry, this is 1. This is not 0, this is 1. Next, it is 0, 0, 1. Next, it is 1, 0, 1. And this continues, right? This is 0. This is negative x. This becomes 1. I'll just continue with this. Okay. Next clock cycle, this becomes 1. Okay. Negative, negative, and this 1, 0, 0, and it will be having next 0, 1, 1. And one make sure that this should never come, right? 0, 1, 1, 1. That is 6. This is MSB. This is MSB. And this is my LSB. This is count 0. This is 1. This is 2. Because 0, 1, 0 is 2. This is 3. 0, 1, 1. This is 4. 1, 0, 0 is 4. 1, 0, 1 is 5. The moment, previously I have seen, the moment Q3 and Q2 becomes 1, my output will be reset, meaning this is what my actual, so this won't become, so this becomes completely 0. And here also, the moment this becomes 1 means, so this won't be there, again this becomes 0. So it is 0 and it will continue. So this is my time axis, okay, and this is my magnitude. Okay, this is what really happens. I can design any mod, okay, asynchronous or ripple counter. Okay, but you should know how to design that. This is the timing diagram. This is the timing diagram for a mod 6 synchronous up counter. This is when it is becomes up counter when I apply a negative edge. Okay, if the flip-flop is positive edge, I get the down counting. That is the only difference here. And this is the mod 6 because it will count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And after 5, the moment 6 comes, I am re-clearing the flip-flop outputs. That's why it will become 0, 0, 0. And what is the next count? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is what? Is this clear? So you can see that 2 cycle of this is becoming 1 cycle. Okay? That means time is doubled means frequency is divided. That's why it is least significant bit is always divided by 2. And you can see that 4 cycles of this is becoming 1 cycle of this. Yes. That means time is multiplied by 4, whereas frequency is divided by 4. It is divided by 4. Yes. And this is something like, if it is a mod 8 counter, it will count from 0 to 7. We call it as something like divide by 8. But here I can't call it as a divide by 8. The only reason is, I'm not having a count from 0 to 7. I'm just having a count from 0 to 5. Okay. So each output of the flip-flop is something like divide by. I can use the counter as a clock divider also. That is the application. Okay. So counter is not only used in having a specific prescribed sequence, but also I can use in dividing things. Okay. So this is all about my asynchronous or a ripple counter. Okay. So this concludes the module 3, that is flip-flop, and part of the application. So in the next module lecture series, we will see the synchronous counter and the next subsequent. Thank you.